You know, when the guys on Jersey Shore perform the elaborate grooming ritual known as Jim Tan Laundry, they may have been onto something. A metrosexual movement that's closing the gender gap when it comes to scrubbing and buffing and smoothing. So when did Tough and Harry give way to sleek and smooth? Well, we sent John Berman to the spa to check out tonight's Sign of the Times.
Merces, Manx, mantihose, my goodness. Don't tell grizzly bear Tom Selleck, but the new manliness of today means shaved bodies, smooth skin, sensational clothes, and heaven help us.
We launched a product called Fresh Balls.
It's all part of a revolution in handsome. Call it Mansome. A force so powerful it led to my first ever pedicure.
We're gonna get mantastic today. We're going to turn you into a mansome, mansome man.
At Bliss Spa in New York City, I met super hip filmmaker Morgan Spurlock. We had our toes done side by side.
See, this is when it starts getting disgusting because, like, things, little bits start flying off the bottom of your foot, like little animals.
I feel kind of badly that you have to deal with my feet, though. I mean, is...
I feel badly that she has to deal with your feet, too.
Why? His new documentary, Mansome, just hit the theaters.
I think there's a great question that the film asks, which is, you know, what does it mean to be a man?
If it used to mean fierce, savage, and hairy, then what's manly now?
If you ask women, I think that they still look at the Brad Pitts of the world, the George Clooney's of the world, Isaiah Mustafa, Old Spice guy. Those guys visually are probably the most perfect guys. If you are a handsome man, you're the breadwinner, then and you're sensitive, manicorn. You are the ever elusive perfect man.
A few years ago, we might have called this metrosexual, a style. But now we don't call it anything. It's pretty much normal.
Like, what percentage of men to women do you get?
I'll say 40%.
Hear that? 40% of their customers are men, getting facials, treatments, even something called a mankini wax. We won't go into details. Mansome features Jason Bateman and Will Arnett enjoying a lovely spa day.
Like, what do you think works best with my face? Because this has been doing well for me.
A hood.
But in truth, it's not comic relief. It's reality.
Great for your face.
Even unlikely women's products are now for men. Take mantihose, for example. Yes, mantihose. Madonna is glorifying the style in her Girls Gone Wild video. Headed down to Saks Fifth Avenue to find out what else is hot in men's fashion.
Wristbands are really hot right now. You're seeing leather, you're seeing beads, you're seeing, just stuff like this.
Not just that, but Spanx.
You know, it's actually, most guys are not wearing this for vanity. It will compress you up to 1 to 2 inches around the middle.
So it just makes you thinner.
It makes you a little bit thinner.
So men are.
How about you? You got any hair in your
ear? Not my ear. The nosies have been getting.
If it's born out of vanity, it is a new kind of vanity.
Who's more vain at this point, men or women?
It's expected of women. So ultimately, I think men are seen as being more vain because now when they suddenly are having to care about it, they're seen as being having much more vanity.
And there are new status symbols where you might never suspect, like this $100 underwear, stretchy and adjustable. $100 sound like a lot?
Keeps you stabilized and your bits and parts in place all day. You wouldn't be surprised if a pair of underwear and a bra cost $200 in the store. So we felt it's time for the men to get that extra opportunity.
You think men have been deprived of the right choices in underwear?
I know I have been.
There you go. Look around. Some guy next to you has super comfortable underwear. Some guys have feet as soft and supple as mine. And some guy out there...
They put their... Fresh Balls on, it's just part of getting ready for the day.
Face it, it's Mansome. I'm John Berman for Nightline in New York.